Hello everybody, my name is Ossi Mäntylahti, and in this video I would like to explain to you how disaster recovery works in Odoosh cloud platform. And let's begin by sharing you a PowerPoint presentation that I have made, which illustrates the topics pretty well, and we can see the main concepts there. Let me just share my screen and sharing PowerPoint now. So when I'm making this video, there has been just a very recent disaster in Odoosh, and Odoosh is a large European cloud provider, a cloud infrastructure provider in France. And they had one of their whole data centers going up in flames. And that really hit the several systems, and they were saying that they are urging their clients to activate their disaster recovery plans. Now, how does disaster recovery really work when it comes to Odoo? There are a couple of things that should be noted. I would like to first talk to you about Odoo environment, how it actually works. Then I am going to show you how the restoring of the online backups work, and then we are going to look at how we are going to restore a system from offline backup. And let's actually write here the last part from deleted instance, so that this will be now correct. So I will be talking to you about all these four subjects. First, let's go a bit through theory. So we are seeing in Odoosh these stages, which are the production, staging, and development. Now the thing is that with Odoo, when you are running an Odoo server, you are always you should always be having it in the production. When you are creating a staging copy, what happens is that Odoo makes a copy of your production database and alters it and puts stuff there that is blocking you from, for example, by sending emails or by sending connecting to your bank to fetch your payment information, etc. There are the details we can talk on a later date, but essentially the staging idea is that you will be you should be trying things out with your production data. So essentially, it is a system with your production data, but it doesn't send out emails, etc. Last one is development. And development actually is a system where the database is having Odoo's demo data. So if you have seen these Mark admins, etc., they are there in the development branches. Pretty much, I never use these development branches. I always just use the staging branches and production branches. I should also be noting that in certain cases, when you are implementing changes that you want then to be delivering to the production, in some systems, you are expected to do the changes in the staging environment, and then you are going to promote that staging environment to the new production environment. Now, this is unsupported. Odoo does not support this kind of thing. So whenever you are implementing changes, you have to do them manually. You have to first try them out in the staging branch, then implement them manually in the production database. The Odoo does not support, like in WordPress environments, there are very often things that you are just changing the staging environment database and sending it out to the production. So let's take a look now at Odoosh platform. And let me open a window here that has the test branches. And let me share Let me share my screen. Yep, share screen, Odoo projects. All right, so here I have now, I am on my Odoo.sh environment, and I want to deploy the test environment and make some changes there. So let's first look at, take a look at the online backups. So I go to here to this test 31, and we can see that I have a main branch here. Let's make a copy of this staging branch. Okay, we have old staging branch here. Let's get rid of it. So we just delete it. Yep. So we want to make a copy from our production database to the staging branch. So we plus click on this plus sign, and then we we just create a new name for the staging branch, and it can be like my staging. Okay, so now Odoo is starting to build it. You will see this blue circling icon. So we can now go to the main branch, connect to the main branch, and this is now the production database, which is what will be opening here. So now we see that I have a studio here, so I have changed the background of to something else. So let's create now with the studio, let's change the background. And change background, and let me select one image there, which is certainly not being used. We can put this guy with the mouthpiece. Okay, so now I have updated the production branch with this this guy, so that we can see, we can easily identify that this is the production branch and it has this. So we can now close this production branch and we can get to the staging branch. In the staging branch, what we can do is we can now connect to the connect to this. And we can see that now we have the guy with the bicycle. So this is still the old version. We can now change this background as well. So let's change the background and let's put here a coffee cup. Oof. All right, so now we have created the background in the staging environment, and now we have created the background in the production environment. So now we have made changes. It's now time to do backup and see what happens. And lesson number one, when you are doing a backup in the Odoo system, when you are doing a backup, you can initiate the backup process with this create backup. And what it does, it makes a backup that has everything, all the instances which we are having here in this system. So this backup will be containing test and the production databases. We will be getting back to this a bit later on. So now we have the backup ready. And now we can go to the main branch again. Let's make a change. So now we once again change the background picture, and we will be putting this girl here. So the girl is now on the main branch. And we go to the staging branch. And we see we have our coffee cup here. So let's change now the background. And we can put bananas here as a background picture. Okay, good enough. So now we have created changes here. Now it is time that we want to restore a backup. So how do we restore a backup? We go to the backup section here, and we can click on the restore. And once I click on this restore, Odoo will be showing me that where do I want to restore this? sorry, not this one. I want to restore it into the main or to my staging. And just for the example's sake, let's restore it to both main and the staging. So I will be restoring it to the main. And I think I can initiate, no, I have to wait until the build process is has completed. Takes a minute. All right, completed. And now restore this also to the staging. So this way you can actually do tests freely in the staging environment. And if you screw something up, don't worry, you can just restore the backup and select that the target is staging. So therefore you will not be losing your work. And now let's see what happens in the production and in the staging. So let's connect now to the production, and we can see that we are now seeing this guy with the face mask. Okay, and we go to the staging, and we connect to the staging. And who knows what we are getting? We are getting the blonde girl as a backup. So we are so the backup contained the backup file contains both the stage of the production and all the staging branches. So if I restore it to the staging, I am getting the backup status from the staging to the staging. I cannot mix them, so I cannot restore to the production from the staging. That is not supported by Odoo. Okay. So now let's see, keeping in mind the Strasbourg fire, let's see that I want to download this backup. Let's get rid of the staging so that it doesn't bother us. We will just be deleting it here, and let's make a new backup. So this backup, it is smaller because it has only now the production branch. So what I want to do now, I want to download this backup and I want to store it to my local hard drive so that I have an offsite backup. So now you are actually seeing new notification backup ready. And now this is something that I want to, I cannot yet download because Odoo took a restore here. We need to refresh this page. Sometimes this doesn't refresh automatically. And we can see that now there is a reason manual. This is the one that I now commanded Odoo to do. This restore is still the one that has both the production and the staging. It just didn't automatically update this list. So I want to store this now to the local hard drive. So therefore, I select download. And now Odoo is asking me, what do I want to do? Do I want to test it or do I want to do an exact dump? In our case, because our intention is that I want to make this as an offsite backup, I select an exact dump. And I want to take the files with me as well. Now, when I click start, Odoo starts to prepare this offline backup, and it will take a minute before it is ready. And after it is ready, I can download this file to my local hard drive, and then I can store it and do whatever I want. So it is going to take a minute, and now you will see that there is a new notification. So the bell icon here is showing where I can download this, and it is here on the download where I can download it. So let me download it. And I set it on the backup test. And let me actually put another yes, so I just changed the file name so that it will be clear. So then what do I do when I want to restore this offsite backup? Let's make a change in our production database so that we will be observing that we are actually getting the restore done properly. So again, we go to Studio, we change the background so that we are able to see, and we can select now this gentleman next to the green screen. So he will be, he is our example that now I have done a change in the production database. And don't worry, he will not be there for long because we are going to be restoring the backup. So now, how do we restore the backup? It is here in the backup, and now we will be selecting import database. Odoo is giving me a lot of import notification, and that's okay because this is a big operation. So it is easiest thing is that I just send it by the like this, and I import it. All right, here goes nothing. And again, Odoo is starting the rebuild process. So, this is actually something that that some people might want to play around and start to drag these to different stages, but it is not recommended. Just let the Odoo.sh work, and you will be doing fine. All right, restore operation has completed. So let's see what happens if I connect here, and who can guess what is the background going to be. And it is the guy, it is a gentleman with the face mask. So we can see that this backup has now been correctly restored from an offline backup. Okay, now let's see that what happens if you really screw up and you drop your production Odoo.sh instance. That is going to be, let's say that we have recently had an experience on this, and fortunately Odoo does support that. So let me share the screen again, and here we are now seeing that we are seeing the Odoo.sh project. And I want to drop my test 31 where I drop this. Okay, we drop it, delete project, and just for the example's sake, delete project also for test number 4. Okay, then so now I have deleted all the branches in the Odoo.sh. We can't see them here anymore. So in order to restore this offline backup now, we need to create a new Odoo instance, and then we need to import the data again there. So let's create a new. Now we are seeing that we can create a new instance, and there is a possibility of selecting an existing repository. If you select an existing repository, this is going to be actually connecting to GitHub, where you are going to be seeing all your possible repositories. And the benefit of this one is that if you have put a lot of add-ons for this repository, you will be seeing that this is the this is where the this saves you a bit of time, but it is not obligatory and it doesn't really help you to restore your data. So let's go and create now a test repository called called test 5 version. I think it was 13. Let me actually double verify this one. Yep, it is here. Yeah, I think it was 13. That's today. This is the Odoo version that is recommended. Okay, still. All right, so now we are creating a new Odoo project. And we are waiting for the build to happen. And once you actually see the build happening, you will be getting an empty Odoo instance. So therefore, we are now going to be seeing that the build process is on our test 5 is going to be completed in a minute. And next thing is that we need to drag this to the main branch and let it build up there. Some people are saying that it is safe enough to that you can just drag it while it is the build is ongoing, but I have seen that there have been problems in Odoo.sh platform when you are making hasty moves. So better always to let the build processes finish so that you will not be running into trouble. And it will not take that long because it is an empty database. We can just drag it to production. And we are seeing that the production build should be actually faster because there are no demo datas there. All right, in a minute, it will be ready. And we can actually see that this number 5 backups is not, it doesn't have anything because it is just an empty instance. So here we go. And we can connect to this database to see how is it going. All right, we can see that it's empty. There's nothing in here. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna import our backup for the test site number 3 for this production site. And you already know this part. So we are getting it here and now we are importing it and we are going to wait for the rebuild. So even though that this site is now test 5 and the backup is from test 3, it doesn't matter. The build process will be successful. You can connect to the database and you will be seeing here in the settings that this is the address that will be there. So later on, when you have everything right, correct, you can just change the address. So, but please let Odoo work its magic and let it be there. So now we can connect to this. And hey presto, now we have this backup restored here, which we took as an offline backup, and we can now see the changes that we applied. So this test 5 is now the contents of the test 3 that we created earlier. I want to talk to you a couple of the finalizing things that we should be taking into account when we are doing the disaster recovery. So after your disaster recovery has been done, you have to be, you may have to upgrade the base component of your Odoo instance. In my example, that was not needed, but this is an advanced concept in Odoo maintenance, that if it is anything a bit more complex than then it is probable that you need to upgrade the base. But it's very simple. You just go to App Store, clear with developer mode on, clear the search bar, look for the base and select upgrade. Then most probably the outgoing email servers are not correctly set. You need to go there. It is developer mode, settings, technical, and then incoming and outgoing emails. Probably the scheduled actions are going to be screwed, so you need to set them manually. And last but not least, if you have not disconnected your database and you are running your from the Odoo license and you are running Odoo Enterprise Edition, it is more than probable that your application, your subscription is still connected to another instance. And you need to raise a ticket with Odoo that they will be transferring this from your previous installation to the system that you just restored. It takes one day, and it is not something that is super urgent, because there is typically something like 30 days time to do this. However, there is also a case that if you are restoring a database that has an expired license, you will be seeing this kind of message in the that is visible here in the bottom of the PowerPoint. And it is in Spanish now, but it says essentially that this database has already been expired. In order to be accessing your data, you need to re-enable your subscription. So you cannot use this thing or what I showed you to access the data that is in the database, but you have not paid for the license. So you need to reactivate the license. It is just something that that needs to be known. So just to short recap on the Odoo.sh disaster recovery. You can manage this in the online system, and that's nice for day-to-day operations. And you can then Odoo backup has the backup itself has all these production and staging environments, so you can directly restore a backup to production or to staging at your will. When you are taking the offline backup, then you need to select that it is an exact dump with file store, and you can restore it whenever you like. But please note that it will be coming with the production and staging environments. And you are also able, if you really screw up and you deleted the Odoo.sh project, you are able to restore that situation as well by restoring the database. So that's all what I have for you today. Thank you all for watching, and have a nice day.